Hi, how you doing? I'm trying to make this quick. Just some more things I've been finding that's interesting. Anyhow, let's listen to this Christine Darg. What's the name of her channel? That's she was talking about Jerusalem channel, all one word kind of. She's talking about the counting of the armor. They have a little wrong, but try to get into this. One thing, just hit different points. Try to blow through different points here. One thing that they count the Omer wrong. Okay, here. But I'll get to a point of why I mentioned that. She's like a Jewish raised Christian, but you know, good channel. Because 3 days after Jesus resurrected, okay, it was first fruits, and it's talking about how he was when he was resurrected, and after that day when he resurrected, at first, that woman, I forgot her name, Mary Magdalene probably, couldn't touch her, but then like soon afterwards, people could touch him, I think the same day, because he had to be presented, like first fruits, he had to be presented up to God. He said he hadn't ascended to his Father yet. So he did on that third day, I think the same day he resurrected. And then that was first fruits, okay. And she was saying how, okay, that's when the Omer begins. Okay, this is not about the Omer, but I'm just going to knock this out here real quick. Yeah, that's true. And the third day after Passover, day of Lord Jesus' resurrection, would be the first fruits in the beginning at that time, at the beginning of the Omer count. But some weeks, but I don't believe you, according to how it's worded in the Bible, you know, King James and the English Bibles we got. It's not always, they count the Omer day, see, they count Omer day one, the third day of Passover, like here, that's how they do it, but really, they should do it the way it's worded. After that Sabbath, they should go to the next Sunday, first day of the week. That should be Omer day one, and that's the way a lot of us count it, and that's, this year it would be June 15th. A lot of people agree nowadays, so that's good news, I think. A lot of people agree nowadays that June 15th is Pentecost, and Pentecost is always on a Sunday, first day of the week, because think about how it's worded. I also want to share this with you. How it's worded, you, from the day it first counted, you count seven Sabbaths, and it comes up to 49 days. If you started in the middle of the week, and you start there and you count seven Sabbaths, that don't give you 49 days. That gives you less than 49. So that's another confirmation to me. That's, no, when it says the Sabbath after Passover, boom, that's the Sabbath. If it said the day after Passover, I believe the wording would have said the day after Passover, not the day after the Sabbath of that week. There's a day after the Sabbath of that week. So there's many reasons. That's just confirmed again. So anyhow, but when, like, and I studied it in the last, what is the next to last video series I did? It's 31 AD, April 31 AD is when the crucifixion, all the signs, all the, is one of the only Passovers that was on a Wednesday or Thursday, which it needs to be in the biblical account, because he raised, what, on Sunday? He was resurrected on Sunday, right? We all agree with that, first day of the week. And so the only one that fits, you know, with the eclipses and everything, is April 31 AD. That day, I ain't going to turn to it here, but then, yeah, Passover was on a Wednesday or Thursday. I forgot which. Thursday, but it would have been Wednesday our time or something over here in the West, beginning of it. I'm just gonna say Wednesday, Thursday, okay. Make it easy. But when the Passover is like on a Monday, which it is sometimes, since it's the 14th day of the week, when it's on the second day of the week, the third day, you know, that commemorates his resurrection, wouldn't be on a first day of the week. It would be somewhere in the middle here. So not only counting the Omer would be wrong, counting seven Sabbaths wouldn't bring you to 49 days. The next day would be the 50th. Also, well, I forgot my next point, but let's go here. Here's something interesting too. You know, where these calendars, they sometimes get it wrong. They do a month early. Another thing about the barley, I watched the channel that shows the barley harvest. Just gonna run this by you real quick. But do you think when they did a barley harvest, do you think it? I seen a video where they showed a woman, you know, going through a field, and some fields didn't have barley. Like in March, some fields didn't have barley at all, really. And some, like, well, I could find one here or there. It's like, oh, well, I could maybe find five strands or something. Do you think that they're going to harvest? I don't know. I don't see people harvesting. It's like, okay, Joe, go out and Daniel or something, go out and get, bring back some barley here. Let's harvest this. Work on this field. And he brings back like a handful. He brings back a strands of, what is it, maybe 20 strands of barley in his hand. He's like, yeah, I found some. And Joe comes back and he's like, yeah, I found a few. He's got a hand. It took him a while to pick and sort through. No. Anyway, I don't want to get into that. But most of us agree now. Yeah, the year began in April now. But when they begin it in March, you know, this incorrectly, that Passover was on a second day of the week. Keep that in mind, okay? It wasn't on a, what's it called? Fourth or fifth day of the week, which it needs to be, to look like how it happened when Lord Jesus was resurrected, April 31 AD. I know it doesn't have to, but the next month does. April, the second Passover. That confused it. April was the first Passover, and it's, we'll get to that. So,
It's the, even the real first Passover. Okay, this is real first Passover, April 22nd, 23rd. It was on a Monday, too. But this one we just seen. The actual second Passover, May 22nd, 23rd. What's that like today? Yeah. That's on a fifth day. So I thought, well, that's interesting. Not the first Passover this year, but the second Passover this year was on a fifth day, like the month when Lord Jesus was resurrected. Just similar, you know what I'm saying? It's like, similar. Another thing, some of these might be big points, some of them are minor, just interesting, you know. And so I was like, well, but they had a penumbral eclipse. That's like a sign. Like, we've seen a lot of those star, moon, and sun signs on these biblical feast days, holidays, our translation for the word. And but I realized that would have been Purim.
that penumbral lunar eclipse, Purim, was March 24th, 25th. So, anyhow, I don't know if you remember that. A lot of people already know that. So, yeah, there was a penumbral lunar eclipse, but that was on Purim there. And that April 8th total solar eclipse was on, like, the day before the beginning of the year. So we had, and I think it fits more, the penumbral eclipse on Purim fits even more. They think it's, if somebody's doing the traditional rabbi, wrong calendar, they already have it pre-planned. They don't even go out, and they don't even do it like the Bible says. You know how that is. They think it's Passover, but actually it's Purim, you know. And it kind of like, it kind of fits too, in my opinion. If you know what Purim is, lots for the, what was it in the book of Esther? It's kind of fitting. And the total, yeah, solar eclipse was on the last day of that year. It's kind of like, okay. The next year begins like the day or two after that total solar eclipse. Just running that by you. But another thing I wanted to say is we know Passover had a resurrection, fulfillment of first fruits when Lord Jesus resurrected, 31 AD. And I was just thinking, I've been thinking lately, like, well, second Passover, it's called a Passover, you know. What's the type of resurrection for second Passover? You hear what I'm saying? First Passover had a resurrection 3 days later, okay? Yeah, we agree. Does second Passover have a resurrection 3 days later? And that would be this year, 3 days after second Passover is May 25th, May 26th. Yeah, it's like that. Let me hear. Yeah. May 25th, May 26th. Which is also, I mean, to me, this is the, I've never liked a, I've been saying for a while now that, as far as I know, in studying the scriptures, the rapture could be any day now. I'm not really big, people give like, oh, watch that. Yeah, it's just a date for an event and or a sign. Like the April 8th eclipse or whatever, yeah, it's a sign. It's a day that a sign is on. But, as I see it, the rapture could be any day now, any day. Since we don't know and we've seen the signs, I count it to be any day now. But if we want to talk about sign dates and signs on days that speak of the rapture of the church, to me, I haven't seen one. I haven't seen a time more impressive than now, and possibly like now to Pentecost. And my total max, if there's a Daniel 70th week still to go, and there is a pre-trib rapture before that, you know, at the beginning of it somehow, which I'm sure of that part, my max is before Yom Teruah, Feast of Trumpets this year, which would be what? Late September? Wait a minute. Let's go ahead. April, May, June, July. April, May, June, July, August, September, October. It'd be like beginning of October.
Isn't there an October 2nd eclipse? I'm gonna see that. Let's check it out. But anyhow, before then, definitely Max. If there's a Daniel 70th week to go, surely. There's even a possibility, even if there's just 3.5 of it to go. But surely if there's Daniel 70th week to go, and there is a rapture of the church at the beginning of it, which that's pretty sure. Whenever the day of the Lord begins, that shit's sure. The church is not going through the day of the Lord. That's solid. That's solid in Scripture. But this, especially this May 25th, May 26th, is the most impressive one I've ever seen concerning the types, signs, everything. And you might know more about the news of what's going on, what the Russian nuke or something. I don't know. I don't pay attention much to it personally, but not much. Because also something with this day, not only is it the third day after second Passover, which hasn't had a resurrection, right? It's the 17th day of the second month, which is in Genesis 7, and we're told, as in the days of Noah, so shall the coming of the Son of Man be. I mean, it's pretty clear the coming is in two stages. First, his appearing for those that look for him, Hebrews 9:28. At least for those who look for him, we know that. And then, you know, at the he comes back like Acts 1 or 2 says. He went up on the Mount of Olives. He said, two stood by and said, why do you look up into heavens? He's going to come back down just the way that he ascended in heaven. So at the end of Armageddon, which is at the end of the sixth vial, technically, I think, sixth or seventh vial, in Revelation, at the end of all that, he literally sets his foot down on Mount of Olives again, comes back down. So, you know, there's two stages. There's also two stages to the fall of the dragon, Satan, too. He was kicked out of the first heaven, and then Revelation 12, he gets another kick down. He's kicked down from the second heavens to earth. Right, that's the whole study. We've studied that over the years. So there's two, you know, but the first, So anyhow, like I was saying, that's also, I mean, second Passover is always the 17th. I mean, the 14th day of the second month. So 3 days after it would always be the 17th day of the second month. Yeah. And that is in Genesis 7 when they surely fully close the door on the ark, and I think that same day the waters came down, didn't it? It said they also loaded in the 10th day of the second month, but also it also says they loaded on the 17th day, and they shut the door, and waters came down. So, and it hasn't had a resurrection, and with all the other signs and the times that we're in, I'm telling you, to me, I mean, it's just me talking here, at least right now. Sometimes it's probably just me talking. It would almost be weird if the rapture didn't happen. Like, around this time, at least. To me, it would just talking business, being honest. It would kind of be weird. We've seen so many things. One thing I talk about it a lot, I think, says a lot, or a recent one. The October 14th, well-born royal birth in Corpus Christi, body of Christ in Natal, pace or time of one's birth. I mean, come on. And then the April 8th one. But that took a little study. I don't know if I could convince people of that quickly. But it spoke to me. Begat it Mazatlan, place of deer. And I studied where deer's in the Bible. Hinds feed on high places. Then it ended in Newfoundland, Buena Vista, good view. That speaks to me. It might not to you. I'll just leave that to you. So the May 25th, May 26th, 3 days after second Passover, also being the 17th day, second month. Yeah. And we know there's a lot of TOL End Times Channel past two or three years has done videos that the 50 reasons for Pentecost rapture. Yeah, it brings a lot of good points, and that's just, you know, June 15th. That's about 20 days away from there. Oh, and here's yet another thing that I heard recently. I need to write them all down. There's a lot of them. I forgot the channel, but I heard somebody say this, and it's in the Bible, but he brought it to my mind, that just the question, why were they going through, what was it, John and a couple of the disciples at least, were going through, I have to go back if you want to direct, but you, scripture, but you could search it yourself. Remember when a couple of the disciples were picking grain on the Sabbath day? They were picking wheat. I don't know. He just had an interesting thought. It's like, why do we get a picture then of a couple of the disciples? The disciples, not just two of them. Some disciples picking wheat on a Sabbath day. I've kind of thought that if we're looking for a rapture on these days, it would be either on a Sabbath day or a first day. You know, makes sense. First day there, picking wheat, meaning that's a kind of harvest, kind of a picture, kind of reminds you of that. Quote-unquote secret harvest, maybe you could say it like that. But anyway, that's just a thought. That's a thought to add to it. But,
Multitudes of souls are being gathered from every nation on earth. After being presented to the Father, Jesus returned to the resurrection garden in time to greet the other women who came to visit his empty tomb. This time, he didn't forbid the women to touch him because the weeks of harvest had begun after the first fruits had been presented to the Father. And for 40 days after his resurrection, Jesus appeared from time to time to his disciples, sometimes behind closed doors, sometimes in the open air, and in encounters such as his conversation with two disciples on the road to Emmaus. He also met with them on the shores of the Sea of Galilee, where he even cooked and ate breakfast with his disciples. And on more than one occasion, 500 of his followers saw him simultaneously, many of whom were probably interviewed by the Apostle Paul, because Paul recorded some of the post-resurrection appearances of Jesus in 1 Corinthians chapter 15. But let me remind you that by ascending to heaven after 40 days, Jesus broke the counting of the Omer, leaving off mysteriously 9 days, so that after only 40 days, he ascended to heaven, leaving his disciples, but they were promised that he would return in like manner as they had seen him depart. The type of the full Omer count has been on hold while Jesus has been absent from the earth. So here's my question. Will the remaining days, adding up to 49, be completed in the future? Well, Frank Payne in his book, The Miracle of Time, suggests that if the type or picture of the harvest is to be fulfilled, 9 more days must elapse and be fulfilled when the same conditions of the first 40 post-resurrection days are restored. I find his suggestion not only fascinating, but plausible, simply because our God is accurate in his types.
Hi. Well, that's another study, isn't it? Hopefully that wasn't too loud. The Sister Darg was talking about the gap from Ascension Day, you know, and Pentecost, really. How that year, there was 9 days between when Lord Jesus ascended and Pentecost, and this year it would be like 11 days because, you know, it's a because this year first Passover was on like a Monday or Tuesday, so it creates a little bit more of a gap between Ascension Day and Pentecost. So it's like 11 days. June 4th is like Ascension Day this year. June 15th is Pentecost. She said the Omer was halted. I don't really understand that yet. That's something that I need to definitely, if we're still here over the weekend, that I could look more into. Well, so, but also, a sister here said can't move past the fact that Shavuot needs to be fulfilled, and the only offering that would be accepted with leaven sin, with leaven, is the church. But we shall see. Yeah, but I don't know. Like I say, either one. And Max, sometimes before Yom Teruah. And Christine Darg there was also saying that somebody was saying, but I don't get it yet. I don't get that yet. I'm going to have to study this, that the days of awe, the 10 days of awe, could be transposed for that gap between Ascension Day and Pentecost somehow, but I didn't really understand how they get that. I don't think she didn't go into it either. Somebody wrote a book or something that had it, but anyway, so just mentioning that, so I don't see so. The most interesting looking ones here is the one that I mentioned, the second Passover time, and possibly the Pentecost. That seems to give the types to me for what that for if we believe in this pre-Daniel's 70th week, pre-trib rapture of the church, from what I'm seeing. But anyhow, I'm just sharing it then. Just sharing it to share it. And let's put it this way. I definitely don't see it at this time, second Passover next year. I definitely don't see that. And just like the thing I mentioned in the beginning, one of the things I mentioned in the beginning here, this year, second Passover is on Thursday, which looks like the way it was when the Lord Jesus resurrected. And I know 31 A.D. is the time when he was resurrected. I'm set on that personally. And you know, minus 7 years, 2024, it ain't 2025. You know, just everything, all that. I mean, the things that we've been looking at, unless we're cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs or something. Yeah. There we go. But personally, I don't think we are that. I think we're on track somehow. And I expect to be gone. So I pray for all the fam in Lord Jesus, and the Spirit and the Bride say, come, Lord Jesus. Amen.